Hi, welcome to Automation Testing That In. In this video, we will see what is API. Okay, so as part of this video, what are the topics we are going to cover? So first, we'll see what are the topics which we are going to cover as part of this video, and we'll see one by one to understand API in detail or easily. So the first point is, what is an API? The second thing is types of API. And the third point we are going to discuss is how an API works. And the fourth point is, what is the purpose of an API? Right, we are talking about the API. Then what is the purpose of that API? Why we are discussing about the API? Okay, so the other point is, what happens when you perform an API call? Okay, and we'll take some examples, more examples to understand the API in detail and easily. So I'll try to give all the information about what we are what I mentioned here. So let's go one by one. The first point is, what is an API? Okay, so what we'll do, first we'll see technical definition of API. Okay, first we'll see technical definition of API, which you frequently see or know. When you search in Google, you'll find so many definitions. We'll see such kind of definition, and then later we'll try to see some examples to understand it easily. So later we'll try to understand by taking some examples. Okay, let's take more and simple examples on API to understand better. Okay, so first we'll see technical definition, then we'll see by taking some simple examples to understand what is API, what is the purpose of API, why we'll use that API, what happens when you use that API. Okay, we'll see one by one. So first we'll see the technical definition. So first we'll see what is API. API means application programming interface. So it is the full form of API. So normally we'll talk API, but what is the full form of API? API means application programming interface. Okay, that is fine. The next point is, it allows two systems to communicate with one another. Okay, so it might be over the internet or without internet also. Okay, so it allows two systems to communicate with one another. Okay, just take an example. We have two systems. So this system is developed using some technology, and the other system is developed using another technology. So both are developed using different technologies. So let's say this is developed on top of using some ABC technology, and the same way this has taken some other XYZ technology. I don't know, and I do not bother about which technology that application is developed on top of. Okay, so now this system wants to communicate to this system. Okay, ABC system wants to communicate with XYZ system, and the same way XYZ wants to communicate with ABC. So how these two systems will communicate, right? So when you go to your daily normal routine, so you will see so many gadgets, technologies, whatever you want. But, and you can observe that one technology or one device is communicating with another device. So how that is happening? Okay, so that we need to understand. So to communicate these two systems, there might be a chance of using internet or no need of internet. So we'll see all the examples when you come to the examples section. So first we'll try to understand some of the points about API, then we'll try to learn one by one in detail. So the next point is API provides the language and contract. Okay, API provides the language, and we need to these two points are important. Contract for how two systems interact. Okay, so we are saying two systems wants to interact, but how two systems will interact? One is using another technology and another is using some other technology. So how these two systems will interact? There should be some common point. So that is, we can say language. Okay, and the same way, how you want to communicate, there should be some contract. So what is this contract? I'll tell you. Okay, so API provides the language and the contract for how two systems interact. And each API has documentation and specifications which determine how information can be transferred. Okay, so when you talk about the API, it is not a simple thing. Okay, so it has the documentation, it has some specifications which determine how information can be transferred. Simply, I can say, hey XYZ, I want to communicate with you. Hey PQR, I want to communicate with you. Hey ABC, I want to communicate with you. It simply cannot happen. In between, if you want to communicate some technology, something should be happened. Then only the two systems will communicate. What is that something? So that we will discuss. Okay, that something is defined by API. Means it will give you some documentation, some specifications to interact with one another. Okay, and just like a web page is rendered. Okay, when you hit any URL, then that URL will load some web page. Okay, the same way APIs can use the same technology that HTTP requests to get information from the server. Okay, so the how you load any page on your web page by hitting any URL, the same way APIs also get the information from the server. Okay, so these are the points technically we'll talk. So API means application programming interface. It allows two systems to communicate with one another. API provides the language and contract for how two systems to interact. Each API has documentation and specifications which determine how information can be transferred. So this is purely technical information. Okay, while taking an example, we'll try to relate all information with this. Okay, so the API means it's a kind of a service. It's providing some service to interact with one another. So for every service, there is, you need to understand some points. You have service provider and service consumer. Okay. So why it has come from API to service? So we'll link all these things one by one. At this point, you just understand that there is a service. I want to use that service. Okay. There are two things. One is service provider. What service provider will do? Which provides the service. Okay. How it will provide the service? It will expose the API which it developed. Okay. And the same way, you have service consumer. What is service consumer? Which makes use of it. Okay. By developing an API, a service provider exposes its API as a service to other service, what we can say, the service consumer. The consumer can use by taking that API. Okay. So this is all technical information which I'm talking. Okay, at this point, it might be not clear to you, but when we are going step by step, we'll relate all the points, we'll connect all the points, and we'll understand what is API, what is the purpose of API, where you will use API. So knowingly, unknowingly, you will use these APIs in your daily routine so many times and so many ways, which you don't know even. So we'll take all these examples and we'll try to understand one by one. So to understand or make it simple, I have taken so many examples, I'll explain one by one. So bear with me at present. So I'm talking all the things technically. If you already know, you'll understand these points. If you are new to API, so it will take a bit time to understand everything, but at the end of the video, it will be very clear that what is API, what is the purpose of API, so why we use API, you know, in which scenario we'll use API, everything will be very clear to you. Okay. So we have a service provider which will provide the API and the service consumer which will use that API to perform its own task. Okay. So, okay, I'm giving the API. So the other person using the API. But how these two systems will interact? And we have said that there is a language and contract, everything, right? So what is the contract you see, right? A consumer needs to know. I'm talking about the consumer, okay? A consumer needs to know the details of the service provided, right? So I'm giving an API, okay? I'm giving an API. I'm exposing my APIs. So the consumer, how he comes to know that, okay, there is an API, how to use that API, how can make use of that API to suffice my requirements, to fulfill my requirements by using that API, I should know, right? So that is the reason. So for this reason, a contract needs to be in place. Okay, there should be a contract, should be in place. And what this contract says, a service contract specifies what it specifies. So what are the inputs and outputs of or from the service. Okay. So I want to communicate to you. What is the input I need to give to you? What you are expecting from me to communicate with me? And the same way, what can I expect from you? Right. There are two systems want to communicate. So if you want to communicate, there should be some input. What is the input? And the input should be understood by the application. All right. So what is the input you are going to give? That is decided by the service provider. So I need this information from you, then I can provide you this information to you. That is what happens in the contract. Okay. So what is the URL at which the service is available? Okay. What is the URL? Means I'm giving some information that you need to use this to get this service. Okay. Everything is fine. I know the input, I know the output, and I know where the resource is available. But two systems simply communicating means what about the security? All right, security matters, right? Everything is secured. If it is my application, I should not expose everything to you, right? So when you're communicating with one system to another system, what is the security you need to follow? Right. How do you send authorization? Means, okay, you are communicating to me, but how we can identify you? That is also specified in a contract. Okay. So when you talk about the authorization, there are so many ways to authorize. What do you say that to interact with one another system, there should be some security. For that, we need some authorization. By using this authorization, you can communicate. Okay. What are the few authorizations available in the APIs? So the first one is, I cannot say the first one. I'm just telling you some of the examples. Okay. Simple means by taking username and password. Okay, I will register with you my username and password. Then by using that username and password, I can consume your service. So the API key, I'll use some keys to prove my authentication. Like this is my API key, just validate this. If it is proper, then we can start communicate. Okay. So we'll say there is OAuth. And what do you say? OAuth 2.0. So these are the few authorizations you will use to communicate one another. Okay. So this is the information about an API, like technically or no, it's kind of definition. So API means application program interface. It allows two systems to communicate, and to communicate what we need a language and we need some specifications. What are those? See, everything can be specified with the API. So when you talk about API, it will expose its APIs to use. For that, there are some services. So if you want to use service, you have a service provider, you will provide the service, and there is a service consumer. So they'll use this service, but simply how it will expose its services and how you can use the service. For that, we have a contract. So in the contract, it will clearly mentions that what information I need to interact with you, and the same way, what information you want from me. Otherwise, this is the information I can provide you. If it is suffice, you just use my service. Okay, to use my service, I need some information from you in the form of input that can be specified in the contract, and where the services are available, and how do you send the, means how you authenticate yourself to interact with one another. Okay, so for that, there are so many ways of authorizations. So you can use simple by using username and password, and you can use API keys, and you use OAuth technology. So there are so many things to communicate with one another. Okay. And now we'll see the second point. Okay. We have seen what is API. Okay. We spoke very technically. When you come to the examples, what are the points which we discussed till now will be very clear at the time. Okay. So the second point is types of APIs. So I'm just telling you what are the types of APIs, and if you want to know about in detail about that type of API, so in the upcoming videos we'll discuss these things in detail. But here, just an introduction about the API. I just want to let you know that there are some types of APIs which we use frequently. One of the frequently used is SOAP API, and the another one is REST. Okay, so what is SOAP? What is REST? What is the difference between these two? Everything we will discuss in the upcoming videos. But in this video, my intention is what is API, and I want to make you understand what is API. Okay, so first, as I said, we'll see everything in technical. So after that, by taking some examples, we'll make it very simple. Okay, and I'm giving you more information that about the API, so it will be very clear when you talk about API to another person. Otherwise, if you want to communicate, or otherwise if you want to say I know API, so what do you know about API? So at the time you can at least talk some points, right? So how an API works, right? How an API works means I have API, so I want to communicate to the other system. Then how can I communicate? So here, I'll talk some points. As I said, we have a SOAP and REST, two types of APIs. How SOAP will communicate to one another? Okay. SOAP relies on XML to provide messaging services. Okay. So as we discussed earlier, I have drawn something. There is one system, another system. Now it wants to communicate with this. How it will communicate? I said there is a language, right? I said there is a language. What is that language? Okay, SOAP uses different language, REST uses different language, okay, to communicate with one another. Okay, so SOAP uses XML to provide messaging services. So in between, we can say it will provide the information, or it will give the input in the form of XML, and the same way it may receive the output in the form of XML. Okay. And the next thing, REST offers more lightweight method using URLs in the most cases. Okay, REST offers means REST offers is a more lightweight method. So when you communicate, REST is a very lightweight technology to communicate with one other system. Okay, method using URLs in the most cases to receive. There's a typo. To receive or send information. Okay, so to receive and send information, and it is very lightweight when you compare with the SOAP. So REST uses mainly four different HTTP verbs. So what are those? Okay. REST uses mainly four different HTTP verbs. So when we are discussing here, you see that APIs can use HTTP requests. Okay. So what are the HTTP verbs? There are some terminology is there. So the terminology it will use. So what is the terminology in detail? We'll discuss everything in the upcoming videos. So here only I want to introduce some of the terminologies, and I want to make you understand what is an API. So one is get and another is post, and put and then delete. We have few more, but very frequently used is get, post, put and delete. By using these things, one system will interact with the another system. Okay. So apart from XML, I think you feel that I am typing so much of information and I'm talking about only technical parts. So when you come to the example section, it will be very clear what I have discussed till now and what we are going to discuss after this also. Okay. So we have seen that how an API works. Sorry. And apart from XML, REST output the data in CSV format, JSON format, RSS, etc. formats. Okay. So SOAP uses only XML, but coming to REST, REST can use XML, otherwise CSV, JSON, RSS. You have so many options to communicate one system to another system. But how will choose from these options? Right. So for that, you can obtain, otherwise user can obtain the output you need in a form that is easy to understand by your application, easy to parse within the language you need for your application. Okay. So REST can give you the output in different ways. Okay. But your application is very much compatible with any one of these. So your application will understand CSV file, CSV format very easily. So you can get the information in the form of CSV. Otherwise your application understands the information which is in the form of JSON. So you can get the information in the form of JSON. Okay. Most frequently used or more used is JSON format normally, but there are so many other options also. So you have so much of flexibility when you use REST rather SOAP. Okay. So that is the user. That is the reason so many companies use REST to communicate with one another in the form when you talk about the API. Okay. And the other point, fourth point is, what is the purpose of an API? Right. We are talking about so many things. What is API? You know, what are the types of APIs? How they communicate with? Then why we need API? Right. Why we need APIs? So APIs to, the first point is to access the data from other service provider. A simple thing, to access the data. And to hide the complexity. What is the complexity? Right. So we'll talk everything. And then to extend the functionality. Okay. And the fourth one is to provide the security. Okay. So when you're talking about the, when you talk about, you know, examples, we will cover each and everything. Okay. Right. We'll cover each and everything. So just remember that, what is the purpose of API? To access the data, to hide the complexity, to extend, not extend, extend functionality, to extend the functionality, to provide the security. Okay. Now we'll see another point. What happens when you perform an API call? So we'll say the communication call calling that some APIs. What happens when you perform an API call? Right, I'm communicating. Right, I'm giving you some inputs. There are two systems. These are the two systems. I want to communicate with one another. I'll give you some input. I'll get some output. But when you call something from this system, when you want to communicate with the system, when you call this system, what happens? When you perform an API call, what happens? That we should know, right? So, typically, what will happen? The first point is, a pass or fail status as response. Right. When I call you, you may respond, you may not respond. There is a chance, right? You may respond, you may not respond. Why you not respond? There might be so many reasons. That is a different concept. But in high level, when I call you, you may respond, you may not respond. The same way, when I call an API, there should be a pass or fail status. Status means when it is successful, you will get some information. If it is not successful, you will get some other information. That we will discuss in our in our next videos. Okay. So, but high level, a pass or fail status as a response. Right. Sometimes what happens? A call to another API. Okay. You are calling other system using an API, but in between there should be another API that will take the input from this API and it will send the information to another API. Means there is not only one API in between, there might be multiple APIs in between these two systems. There is a chance. So when you perform an API call, it might be a direct pass or fail, otherwise a call to another API. So it might give the information to another API also. And the rest of the things can be taken care by that API. If it is a perfect call, if there is any failure, then obviously it is the point one. There may be a chance of pass or fail. And the third point, data or information as a response. Right. I called you and it is successful. The other service provider will give you the information what you need. Data or information as a response you will get. Okay. Only these outputs. I have some doubt. Only these things will happen when you perform an API? No. I am saying data or information as response. Sometimes no output I'll get. Okay. There is a chance no output I'll get. Otherwise, I'm getting some output, but unpredicted output. The information which I'm getting, I do not know. I cannot understand what you're sending, whether it is correct or not. I don't know that information also. Right. So because of these reasons, we will test APIs. Right. We know API testing. The purpose of what I'm talking about here is you do API testing. Why you will do API testing? Right. There are two systems. They are communicating. There is a contract. There is a language. Everything is fine. But even though there is a chance of failure, there is a chance of unpredictable output, there is a chance of no output. So I want to make sure that the API call is working perfectly for which it is intended. For that reason, we will test the API. Right. So how you'll do API testing, what are the tools you'll use, how to use that API or tool, we will discuss in our next videos as part of this series. But here only just I'm giving you in detail information, means introduction about API in detail. Okay, so I'm talking about what is API technically, and types of APIs, you know, how an API interact with another API, means how an API works between two systems. So what is the purpose of an API? What happens when you perform an API call? Okay, so we have seen these 5 points. Now we'll take few examples and we'll try to understand what is API in general terms. Okay, so I'll try to explain, otherwise by taking so many examples we'll try to understand. Okay, API means, don't think that what you do in your daily activities in the office, I'm saying in the office, if you are a API test, if you are a tester, you want to test API, so only don't restrict your mind into that API. So think broadly to understand what it is exactly, then you can test or you can understand API properly. So now we'll discuss examples. Okay, so let me take one simple example first. Human communication. Okay, there are two persons, right? There are two persons. I can say here is one person and there is another person. This person wants to talk to this person. Okay, so just think how a person talks to another person using a language, right? Using a language, that is fine, but which language? Right, which language? So that time, what is the, so API means it's an intermediate between two systems. Okay, intermediate between two systems. So here, what is the medium? You can say medium between two systems. So here, what is the medium? Language. So, but what language? You have n number of languages in the world. Okay, then this guy is from India and this guy is also from India. Okay, even though I cannot communicate, this guy is from one state, this guy is from another state, his mother tongue is different, his mother tongue is different, so I don't know this mother tongue and I don't know his mother tongue, then how you can communicate, right? How you can communicate, but I want to communicate. So that is the reason. Just assume this is a different system and this is a different system. They both want to communicate. So for that, we should have a common thing. So here I can use one common language which is understood by this person and this person, right? I can say English. This person knows English and this person knows English. So I can simply use that English to communicate to this person. That is what an API between me and other person. In this video also, I'm using English to communicate to you what is an API. But after uploading it to the YouTube, this video, there may be a chance of Indian may watch this video, a Russian, an American, a person from UK, a person from China, any person can watch this video. But how those people will understand what is API? That is the reason I'm using very common language which is understood by everything, means most of the persons in the world. So that is the reason I have chosen English to make you understand this. So most of the people can understand English. That is the reason I'm using, that is a medium to tell you what is API. So here English is the medium. English is a kind of API that will make you understand what you want between two persons. Okay, this is human interaction between two persons. So I can say human communication using one common language. Okay, that is one thing. So another thing, and which you frequently saw in some of the videos or some of the blogs, they'll use food order in hotel. Okay, food order in hotel. What happens when you go to the hotel? So when you order something, for that you will use the waiter. A waiter will come to you and he'll ask you that, what you want to eat. Then you will say X, Y, Z, something like that. But there is a kitchen, it will come from the kitchen. But you can directly interact with the kitchen, right? You directly get into the kitchen and you will ask. So there is a restriction. So the first thing is kind of security that nobody will allow you to get into the kitchen. That is one thing. And there is a chef. Chef may not understand what you're telling. Most of the time, chefs will be some other country also sometimes in your restaurant. So the waiter can understand what you're telling and he will communicate the same thing to the chef and he will act as a medium, he or she, whatever it may be. The person, the waiter will act as a medium between you and between the chef or kitchen. So here the medium is the waiter. Waiter acts as an API in between you and the kitchen when you consider this example. Okay, so this is just a very common example which you frequently see in your day-to-day life. And the third one, you will see weather API, right? So when you go to some of the websites, they'll display what is today's weather, what is the temperature, it is, there is a chance of rain or not, something like that. Okay, let's assume I have one application. I want to show weather information. I want to show weather information on my website. So what I need to do? Right. So I cannot roam around the world second by second and I'll not get the temperature from each and every city and each and every country. Right. I'll simply say India, otherwise capital of India, Delhi. Otherwise, I'll say Hyderabad, I'll say Bangalore, I'll say New York, I'll say some Beijing, I'll say some London, something like that. So when I say some city, it will give me the temperature at that city. How I'm getting that information? Okay, so let's assume I have one application I want to show weather information. There is another application which I don't know, whatever it is, some other, they also wants to show weather information in their website. Let's assume. Okay, so now this person, or means this application, needs weather information, this application needs weather information. And tell me, when you say London, this application shows different temperature and this application shows different temperature, then that is not correct. Let's assume there is a 10 degree centigrade. Then this application should 10 degrees and this application also should show 10 degrees only. So you are displaying the same information. Right, you are displaying the same information. For the same information, the purpose is same. I want to show the weather information. That is a common thing between these two applications. So if you want to show, I need to develop that application to show here. And this person also wants to show the application, the information which he wants to show. Then there are n number of websites wants to show weather information. So each person has to develop the same thing which is already available, means which is reusable. Okay, so that time there are some weather APIs available. Somebody will take that pain and they'll develop that API and they'll give you. That might be free or there might be cost. But anyhow, if you want to develop, you have to spend some money, right? So instead of spending that money and you are wasting so much of time, which is already available. So that time there are available APIs and weather. So they will choose one API which is suitable for you. Okay, let's assume there is readily available API. Okay. So available, you can say API available. Right. So if the API is available, then why to develop the same thing in your application? So get the information from here and show. So here is the how this application will give you information to you or to this application. Right. How it will give you the information to you. Sorry. You can say like, so how you'll get the information from here to these applications? So there they will, these people will expose APIs. So you will consume that API and you can show that information in your website. So for that purpose, you need to provide some information input. I can say, this guy will say, send me the city name as input. I'll provide you the city name and city temperature both as output. Okay, you're sending only one input. So you're getting two outputs. When you send city, I'll provide you the city name back and that city's temperature back. That will comes in the form of XML, JSON, RSS, CSV, whatever it is. But your application will understand JSON easily. So get the information from in the form of JSON and show in your application. Why to develop again and again? This guy understands XML, so he'll get the information in the form of XML and he will show the information in the form in his, the weather information in his application. Simple. Why to spend the time? Why to spend the money for the same thing? While getting this information, you can display how you want. Means the UI might be changed, right? The look and feel of your, it should match your the theme which you are maintaining in the application, right? But the data is the same thing. The data is same thing. So we are discussing here somewhere the purpose of to access the data, right? I'm accessing the data from that API. To hide the complexity, what is the complexity here? To capture the information from the world, it is not an easy task to get the temperature from each and every city, each and every place. That you are avoiding by consuming that API. You are not taking that pain. You are not seeing that complexity, what is behind that API, right? And we'll talk about the extend functionality and provide the security also. But we covered these 2 points, right, in this example. And the very frequently you will see that flight reservation, right? So flight reservation, there are so many websites that will provide you the flight information. So how they'll provide you the information, right? How they'll provide you the information. There is a site, there are some sites called Make My Trip or hotel booking also. Sometimes not only flight reservation, hotel bookings. The same. Here one website, it will show the flights information. But how it will show the flight information from the different flight services, right? There is a Lufthansa, there is an Air India, there is a SpiceJet, there is a so many flight providing services are there. So, but when I search here from some Delhi to London, so it will show me so much information that comes from where? That comes from different websites, right? How it is showing that information? It is showing that, you know, what is the time, okay? I just give that information. What is the information I'll give? From to date. Normally, from where I'm traveling, from where do I want to travel, and which date I am traveling. That information you will provide in this website. Then it will give you so much of information back. So on the date, these are the service providers are there, and this is the service name, and this is the time, and this is the time so many flights are there in a single day, and this is the fare. So the input what you are giving, the from, to, and the date, and what is the output you are getting? you are getting from where, the date, what are the timings, different flights, what is the fare, what are the discounts, everything you will get, right? To communicate with each other, it will not directly communicate to this one. It will not allow you to get into the database of this application, right? Then what is the security of maintaining the data in the database? So that is the reason it will restrict you to not get into the application, means the database or what is the application. You just, I'll expose you some APIs to you. Use that API. The contract is this one. You need to send only this information to me. I can understand what you are sending. I will provide you this information back to you. If it is okay with you, communicate with me. Right? Then these people will consume that API. These people will provide only that information. So here, the API will give you security also. You need to maintain the security. Don't get into that, into your application to access your database. Only I'll expose the API, consume that API, provide me the input, I'll give you the output. Okay, there APIs will helpful. While getting the help API, you can get in the form of XML, you can get in the form of JSON, whatever it is. Okay. When you take other example, when you visit somewhere, when you're filling some form, it will ask you for the countries information, drop down, something like that. So in that countries drop down, it will show all the countries in the world. So you have readily available this API also. You can get that API and integrate with your application. It will show all the countries. If there is any change tomorrow, in the country, if you have so many states, if there are some states increased, some states decreased, that information auto populates into your application. If there is any change, you no need to get that information and put into your application. If you consume that country's API, they'll take care of all these things. Then you'll get the updated information, right? The same way we can talk about payment gateways. So when you're doing online purchasing, you'll go to the paying your money, right? There are so many options: net banking, credit card, debit card, some third party apps. So you can say so many people use PayPal. So what is this? It's a payment gateway service. It will provide you the secure communication between two systems, right? So this PayPal is readily available. If you have a shopping website, why you need to develop again the payment gateway for your application? That is, there is a readily available PayPal on the API. So you'll consume that PayPal API and you'll integrate into your application. That's it. How critical it is inside, in behind the scene PayPal, what is the pain it took? So it has to communicate to the banks, and it needs to send some information securely. It needs to get the information securely. Everything, there is so much of thing behind that, that you don't bother about all these things. You just use that API, PayPal, you'll get the things done. Right. Sometimes when you go into that some sites, if you want to sign in, that time what you'll use? They'll allow directly, you can directly register there. Otherwise, using your Google account, your Facebook account, your LinkedIn account, right? You'll see all these options. So instead of you giving the information again and again in this website, use the Google. Already you have a Google account. Use that same account to sign into this, register into this website. That time what happens? Google exposed one API and this guy is consumed that API. So when you say Google, then it will use the same credentials which you are using for the Google into this application. So it will interact with that Google, and then from there, the same thing. It will restrict you there only. So it will check the credentials which you sent. It is whether it is fine or not. If it is okay, so it will allow you to get into this application. Okay, this is one of the examples. And the ATMs which you use, and some third-party APIs, sorry, apps. I'll show you that. Okay. Let me go to the PPT. So here, these are, here you'll have a presentation layer, business layer, and the database layer. It's a simple thing. In the presentation layer, you'll get the request and response to the business layer, and it will query the data from the database. Then it will come to the data to the business layer, and that business layer will show the information in the presentation layer. So in the presentation layer, you'll perform GUI testing. So for that purpose, you'll use Selenium or some other tools to do this GUI testing. In the business layer, you'll perform the API testing. Okay, for that, you'll use Postman, REST Assured, some other things. Okay, just an example here I'm giving. So when you come to these examples, let's assume there is an ATM and there are few ATM cards we have, ICICI, Citibank, so Deutsche Bank, HSBC, so many, but I do not have account in this bank. So Ready ATM, in the Ready Bank, I do not have any ATM. Sorry, I do not have any account, but there is a chance that you can use your ICICI bank card and you can withdraw money from this ATM. How it is happening? The same API concept. So you will insert this card into this ATM. The moment when you insert, it will read some information from this card. It will send this to the ICICI server. The API which they expose, it will allow you till there only. Till there only. It will not allow you to get into the ICICI bank's server. From there, ICICI will take care of that information. Okay, I got the information from you that the card which you inserted is correct. And wait, I'll do what you want. So the authentication happens. The next, I'll say, I want to check my balance. I'll say, simply check that the information which I sent is check balance. So there is another API, check balance API. So it will communicate to the ICICI. Then it will restrict there. Okay, wait, I will check the balance, means it is interacting with another API, okay, that we discussed. What happens when you perform an API call? It may call another API. There is another API. It will take the information from this API and it will send it to the ICICI bank server. There it will check that information. It will give you that information. This is the balance, $1,000 or 1,000 rupees. It will send that information back to this API which is waiting. So that API will show you the information on the screen. Okay, you have $1,000. How it is happening? Through APIs only. Okay, this is one of the daily. So you are using your ATM card in the daily, you know, life, but so many people doesn't know that behind the scenes APIs will work. Okay, and the same way. So I want to log into Trello. This is the application. But if I want to log into the Trello, I want to register here. But there is a chance that login with Google here. Okay. You see that? Login with Google. So I'll choose this option, then it will interact with the Google database. The reason is Google is exposing that sign-in API by the Trello, using that API to interact with the server, and you can authenticate and you can log into this application. And the same way, when you're using GoToMeeting application, you want to sign into that. Here also you see that there is a Facebook API, the GoToMeeting using to sign in. So Google, LinkedIn, Microsoft, there are four options. Here only one option. So then it will interact with the Facebook server and it will allow you to. How these things are happening? Through APIs only. It will expose an API, it will consume. It will expose that API, it will consume. Okay, this is one of the examples. So when you go to the next one, you see I'm using some third party apps. You see that there are so many options. One of the options I can say, this is one API and this is another API which I'm using. Okay, both applications allowing me to pay the electricity bill. Here you see electricity bill. In the same way, If you go back here also, electricity bill. From both the applications, I can pay my electricity bill. How it is happening? That electricity board is exposing some APIs, and this app is using those APIs. When you provide your consumer number here, it will fetch the data, how much money you have to pay. Then you can pay from there. While paying, you will use some third-party APIs as the PayPal, whatever it is. So that is also integrated with, you know, this application. So many APIs this application is using. Right, here also, everything is in the form of APIs. Those are the behind the scenes. Okay. And let me tell you another example. Okay. Give me 1 second. I'll go back to here. Some third party APIs. And coming to your mobile. Take your mobile. In your mobile, you have, what is a scanning document application? Okay, you'll have some applications, right? In the scanning document application, how you'll scan when you go there? If you say scan, it will start your camera, right? It will start your camera. Otherwise, if you want to take a photo, it will start your camera. The camera is your phones, not that applications, right? The camera came with your mobile. If it is Samsung, if it is Apple, whatever it may be, you'll have that when you buy that product, you'll have that camera. But some third party API, which you install from your Play Store, whatever, Google Play Store or App Store, that is using your what? Camera, which is there inside your mobile. How it is accessing that camera? Inside the mobile also, you have some APIs, right? So this application uses your mobile APIs to interact with this camera, right? So when there is a scanning document application, there is a photo taking application, you have n number of applications, you cannot insert one separate camera to your mobile. They'll not provide any separate camera to you, right? We have only single camera, which is already came with your mobile. These applications are using that camera by using some APIs, which is exposed by your mobile, right? So day to day life, you are using all these things. So API is everywhere, right? This is one of the best examples. So while giving that, it will allow you to only some part. There will be security from your mobile. And there is a share market. There are so many TV channels will show you scrolling the shares information, live share information. How they'll show that information? So there is some red API that will show that share market information. They'll consume that. They'll show on the screen of your TV. When you go to that channel, they'll not develop that separate application to show that share market information. There are readily available APIs to display that share market information. That is one of the examples, right? So these are the examples to make you understand that what is API in your day-to-day life, how that is useful, where you are using this. So you might use ATMs, you are paying your utility bills, you are using your mobile camera, right? You may flight reservation, you see some weather in your some applications, right? In the day-to-day life, everywhere you are seeing this, but you don't know where you are using these APIs, okay? Some is technical, some is not technical, whatever it is, but the motto of API is to communicate with one another, which do not understand each language, their language, right? So to make it understand, there is a common thing that is called API. So it will use the common thing between these two systems and will try to communicate. Okay, so we have seen everything, right? So to access the data, you are retrieving the data. So you are hiding the complexity. So extend the functionality means, let's take one of the examples like you use in the TVs or for your fan or light, you'll use, okay, Google provided services, you're giving your voice commands, right? So you're extending the functionality which is given there. You'll integrate into your the things, and you're extending the functionality of that API. Right? If you say, okay, Google, switch on the TV. Hey, Alexa, switch on the TV. Means, so they are providing that information. You're extending the functionality of your TV. You're extending the functionality of your fan. You're extending the functionality of your car. You're extending the functionality of your light, whatever it is. So the purpose of light is you have to switch, and for that you need to use the switches. But by using this, you're extending the functionality of your things, right? That's where you can extend the functionality of something, whatever it is, which is, you know, allowing that to be, you know, added into your TV, car, whatever it is. So provide the security. It's not simply allow you to get into the databases, right? It will provide the security also. Right. This is the information about what is API, types of API, how an API works, what is the purpose of that API, what happens when you perform an API call. And I have taken so many examples to understand what is API, right? And then the starting point, I have used only technical words. When you coming to the examples, I have shown so many simple examples which you use in your daily routine. Okay. So that's all about API. So please provide your comments. So it's a big video. I want to make you understand each and every point. So please provide your comments in the comment section, how you felt after watching this video. Okay. That's all in this video. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. So for further updates, thank you.